We will continue. The UN Charter has defined the following as key healthcare human rights, and they are being violated as I speak. Availability. Functioning healthcare facilities and services must be available in sufficient quantity within a community. Violated! Accessibility. The facilities and services must be accessible physically in safe reach for all sections of the population, including vulnerable groups. Violated! Participation. The beneficiaries of healthcare services should have a voice in the design and implementation of policies that affect them.
That's right.
Violated! And accountability.
Yes.
Duty bearers appointed and elected, not burger, should be accountable for meeting human rights obligations in the area of public health.
Is that in our lifetime we can end the AIDS epidemic as we know it.
That's right.
We have the tools to end this epidemic, and we just need a commitment from the UN and the world leaders and the revenue to do it. A financial transaction tax revenue tax is the way we do that.
That's right.
So there are two significant events that are happening today. First, this is the opening day of the United Nations General Assembly. That means that we are in the presence of all the world leaders.
Can you hear us?
And the one thing that they'll be talking about is their failure to meet the Millennium Progressive Goals, which include addressing world poverty and health issues, which include AIDS and HIV. The second event is that today is the second anniversary of Occupy Wall Street. This is a movement that was started to address the inequality in revenue disbursement and the 1% dominance over the 99%. And that ain't right.
That ain't right!
If you look towards Second Avenue, you will see leaders of the AIDS community who are stopping business as usual. We are going to disrupt, erupt, and confuse the powers that be until they recognize that we need an RHD here in the United States of America. Are you with me? And everybody head towards Second Avenue right now!
sending money downtown to Wall Street, driving a down under on subway services for New Yorkers. To speak more about this, we got speed downs from the Transport Workers Union Local 100.
Brothers and sisters, my name is Steve Downs. I'm the Chief of Staff of Transport Workers Union Local 100. I'm also a train operator in the New York City subway. For the last 2 years, we've been trying to negotiate a new contract with the MTA across the street. We haven't been able to because Governor Cuomo has insisted that they maintain a position of 3-year wage freeze and that we have to increase payments for our medical benefits roughly $5,000 per member per year. We said no, we refused to make those concessions. A dozen other state workers' unions in the state have settled on those terms, but we've said no and we've held up Governor Cuomo's train to take those concessions. Our position is simple. We want a very modest wage increase to keep up with inflation, and we don't want to be spending thousands of dollars for medical care, and we want to save. We want a safe job, and we do not want any increases in fares to pay for this. There's a simple solution to this. Every year, the Transit Authority pays $100 million to Wall Street banks as part of what's known as an interest rate swap.
That's crazy, man!
That's corrupt!
They pay a certain amount of interest, they then turn around and make deals with Wall Street banks which guarantee Wall Street a steady flow of income, a steady interest rate, even if the interest rates drop, as they have since 2008. As a result, $100 million is taken from the fares that you pay to go directly to Wall Street Bank instead of to maintain service or to pay a fair contract to New York City's transit workers.
They're corrupt! You're damn wrong!